This is the third tech video in a row. In the first one we finished the installation. In the second one we prepared the configuration. In this video we actually are going to perform the device configuration. We will start with the AMC controller. The tool for scanning the network for the availability of a controller is the AMC IP Config Tool. We scan the network. And we discover the RS485 AMC controller with static IP address 192.168.2.26. We could also check, but not modify, the IP address on the AMC controller display. Now that we know the controller's IP address, we can start configuring the AMC in the AMS Config Tool. We navigate from configuration to device data. We see that the DMs and the MAC are already in the device list. Before we can add the AMC, we need to set an MAC-based DTSL password to secure the communication between MAC and all its AMCs. Just for the demo, we accept a not-so-safe password. Now we can add the controller to the device configuration. The IP Config Tool told us that the controller was a RS485 type AMC. The detected IP address can now be entered. Next thing to do is enable the communication between the AMC and the PC. The AMC configuration is done and can be saved. Now we can create the entrance, the door and the readers. We start with an entrance and the type is common door with entry and exit reader. So we have an entrance reader. That will be the Bosch Lectus Select reader with on-screen keypad. The keypad is used as extra security, so that a user by entering not only needs to present its card but also type a PIN code. The outbound reader does not need the same extra security. So that will be a normal Lectus Select reader without keypad. Remember from the previous video, part 2 preparation, that we had an office building with a main entrance on the left side of the building, so we rename the entrance to become main entrance. In preparation we also created an area and called that office building. The area outside was pre-configured, so the new created main entrance brings us from the location outside to the destination office building. The door with the two readers, that brings us in and out the building will be called main door. Let's rename that as well. There is a reader that lets us in. We referred to that as inbound reader. That was the reader with a keypad. We rename the reader to its direction, outside in. We want to require the user to enter a PIN code before allowing access. So in the reader's options we turn the PIN code on. There is also a reader at the inside. That will allow us to exit the building. That reader is without keypad. Of course we will rename that one to inside out. So this is what we configured so far, an AMC RS485 controller. One entrance, with a door and two readers, one that lets us in, and one that lets us out. Here is the map view again. Let's put it in edit mode. We click on the device browser that presents us all configured servers and devices. When we scroll down, under entrances we will discover the devices that we configured so far. We will first drag the main door to its real location. Let's give the door a nicer look by shrinking the icon and making it transparent in the icon settings. We repeat the procedure with the two readers. So now we have created the actual configuration on the map view. When events or alarms happen with doors or readers, that will be reflected on the icons by exclamation marks. Also, there will be a link between the event and the icon. Clicking the event flashes the corresponding icon. This ends the video about AMS device configuration. Next video to watch is part 4, Personnel and Cards.